good morning. It's great to be with you and bring you a word that will give you hope, even though this is no longer called Dose of Hope. It's a word of hope. One of the things I love about our relationship with the Lord is that He's with us. And so I want to talk about that, and hopefully it'll be something that helps you, not just this day, but every day. So one of the most familiar scriptures regarding this would be out of Psalm 23 that says, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil because you are with me. And this theme that God is with us is all through scripture. It's the essence of salvation. In fact, God, of course, is everywhere in an imminent way, but He's with us personally as believers. And it's why our life changes. When we meet Jesus, we come to Him and He comes into us. The Holy Spirit comes into us. And if we knew that, it would deliver us from every fear. It would deliver us from abandonment, insecurity. It's awesome. I'm still working on it after more than 40 years of walking with Jesus. But what a great promise that I'll fear no evil. You're with me. Perfect love casts out fear. When He's with us, perfect love is with us. Sometimes we think love is a to-do list, but love is a person. Love is God in us. So how do we touch this? I mean, there's so much where He manifests Himself, that so many great stories. Probably the things, when I was a new Christian, the things that surprised me over and over again would be moments where I knew God was with me, like I got a break. And there was no explanation for it other than God. One time, I foolishly tore apart the engine from my Volkswagen bus in the garage of an estate that we were caretakers. We lived in a little 9x21 apartment, if you want to call it that, room on the end of the garage, uninsulated. In the winter, it was really cold. And the owners weren't there, and my Volkswagen bus was broken down, which is common for Volkswagen buses, any of you that lived through that era. And so I had it completely torn apart. A valve was burnt, and I had the heads off. And unannounced, the owner's son, who was about 50 years old, the owner was 80 and loved us, like we could do no wrong in his sight. But his son was grouchy. And he shows up, and he opens the garage door, and he sees this Volkswagen engine torn apart on the floor. And I just thought, like, oh, no. So I repented, and I poured out my heart to God, told Him I was sorry, I was such a sinner, and I did this terrible thing. And I cleaned up the engine, I got it all organized and neat and had it all on paper, and you know, there was no mess left on the garage floor. And later, and the Mr. McLeod was his name, the son's name, he was an attorney, and he had gone off to the main house. So a few hours later, I saw him in the yard. He said, hey, I looked in the garage, you know, it looks really neat, there's no problem. And he says, and by the way, thank you for filling up the wood box so that they had wood for the fireplace in the big house. And this was crazy because I hadn't put any wood in the wood box, but the wood box was full, and he thought, he ascribed this good deed to me, and he liked me instead of hated me. And I just thought, God, I can't explain this, but you're with me. And so I said, you're welcome. And I gave thanks to God. And I knew He was with me. And it's like that over and over again. Here's a Psalm 42:8. I love this. It says, in the daytime, He commands His loving kindness or His steadfast love to us. And in the night, a song, His song shall be with me. A prayer to the God of my life. Have you ever experienced that, where in the middle of a dark night, there's a song in your heart? It's the song of the Lord. He's giving you His prayer because He's with you. On and on it goes. We know the great commandment. Jesus said, I'm with you to the end of the age. So He's with us. If we could walk in that, we would be, our whole lives would change if we're aware that he's with us. So I want to give you a little practical step here that I practice in my own life, sometimes great and sometimes not so great. But in the morning, when you arise, you know, we all have different routines, and maybe you decide, I'm going to do this in the evening before I go to bed. Or, but at some point in the day, I do this in the morning, that you just sit or kneel or stand, whatever works for you, and welcome the presence of Jesus. He's with you. But take time. Like, don't read the newspaper. Don't even work on your verses for the day. Just for a moment, stop and just maybe 5 minutes, maybe a little longer, but just wait on the Lord until you sense his presence, because he's not just with us in theory, he's with us in reality. And he'll speak to us, and he'll guide us, and he'll speak through us. But so that's it. The Lord is with me. That's your homework or your gift. And when he's with you and you're aware of it, you'll receive a supernatural song in the midst of difficult circumstances. He'll be your song in the night. He'll be that word of wisdom you get when you're in a difficult situation. So that's it. Just work on it day in, day out. It may not be perfect the first time. And here's the thing, you know, if you start to recognize his presence with you, you can stop at various times during the day and just say, am I aware that he's with me? Am I aware? And pretty soon, you know, it's like breathing. He's with you all the time. And when he's with you, the God of hope is with you. The God of peace is with you. The peace that passes understanding is yours. And so I'm going to pray for you. Lord, thank you that you're the God of hope. I pray for everyone listening to this that you, the God of hope, would fill them with all peace and all joy as they trust you, so they would overflow with hope as they steward your presence. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a blessed day.